Cities across the globe are drowning in cars, with immense impacts on their quality of life. Cycling is part of the solution, yet the reallocation of space remains painfully slow and inconsistent. So how do we reframe the conversation and tell a broader story, in the words of Dan Piatkowski, not about making cities better for bikes, but making them better with bikes? As a cycle campaigner in Vancouver, a city that can relate to the challenges of car dominance, I first traveled to the Netherlands in 2016. And instantly fell in love with its effortless cycling culture. That summer was nothing short of life-changing, and witnessing the sheer number and diversity of people cycling strengthened my resolve to push for better infrastructure in my own community. It wasn't until I moved to Delft in 2019 that I realized, despite writing an entire book on the topic, the Dutch blueprint for urban vitality was not about bikes. It was about refusing to sacrifice vast amounts of public space to the private automobile, instead reserving it for commerce, community, and social connection. The bicycle was simply a means to achieve that end goal of a more livable city. But like fish have no clue they're surrounded by water, most Dutch people fail to understand the amazing ways that they've shaped their cities. So in addition to the externally facing work at the Dutch Cycling Embassy, my job became about raising awareness within the Netherlands, helping the public and government institutions better appreciate their own accomplishments. So you can imagine my delight when, after the pandemic, forced a reset on global travel, the Netherlands Board of Tourism and Conventions released a strategic shift to no longer increase the quantity of international visitors, but increase their quality. And along with design and water, cycling became one of three focus topics to spread tourism spend more equally across the country. After a soft launch of their cycling campaign, plans were hatched to develop a symbolic action, an imaginative and interactive initiative to enhance their brand and draw attention to its strategy. At its heart was an AI-based tool that allowed anyone from around the world to reimagine any street by making it greener, literally and figuratively, by adding a touch of Dutch. Once the tool was developed, it was introduced with a digital campaign under the hashtag #BringYourself, encouraging visitors to be themselves and go with the flow. From Mama Agatha to the Headwind Championships, many individuals and initiatives were spotlighted, sharing their own passion for cycling and its potential to create a healthier and more sustainable world. Complementing these digital efforts, a physical campaign of strategically based advertisements was launched in Brussels, Dusseldorf, London, and Paris. Vibrant billboards along congested routes featured dynamic before and after photographs, sparking interest in the tool. It was a poetic reclamation of space that had previously carried messages from SUV manufacturers. For those of us in this field, there was a rare opportunity to compete with the infinite resources of the automobile industry, to get outside of our echo chambers and reach a mainstream audience. Suddenly, tens of thousands of pedestrians, cyclists, public transport users, and motorists were confronted with a new vision of their city, one that reduced the car's hegemony on their streets. The first of its kind on the planet, the Dutch Cycling Lifestyle AI tool launched in October 2023 and was an immediate hit. With just a few clicks, it transformed streets around the world into typical Dutch streets with plenty of walking, cycling, and green space. The user was then offered four variations and encouraged to share the miraculous makeover on their own social media circles. Once again, breaking out of the bike bubble, the NBTC pitched the story to media in core markets of Germany, Belgium, France, the UK, and the US. This involved approaching regional and national media with context-specific hooks to influence the local discussion on mobility and livability. These stories reached an estimated 7.5 million people within these five countries. Within a month, the tool had been used over a million times. From New York to New Delhi, corridors were given a bike-friendly overhaul and shared online with their users' experiences and enthusiasm. The reaction took the NBTC by surprise, exceeding expectations and forcing them to increase bandwidth several times because the demand kept on growing. Needless to say, this symbolic action was an immense success, furthering the NBTC's goal of establishing strong international position and attracting investment, talent, students, and visitors to the Netherlands. The Dutch want to be known for co-creating solutions to global challenges in an open, inventive, and inclusive way. Positioning ourselves as a cycling country is now a key part of that goal. The 1.5 million images did not go unnoticed in the industry. In April, the Dutch Cycling Lifestyle tool was nominated by a prestigious Webby Award in the Virtual Public Service and Activism category, where a jury named it runner-up. In May, it placed first in the Dutch Interactive Awards in the AI Applications category, and second in the digital for good category. While it's now in its concluding phase, the NBTC has sought ways to leave a legacy that benefits as many people and parties as possible. They've already made the code open source through the well-known GitHub platform, and in the fall of 2024, they will organize a hackathon to improve the tool and its underlying code, focusing on its speed and producing better visuals. So what does this teach us about accelerating the urgent shift to cycling? Well, if you let me step on my soapbox for a moment, I'll start by pleading with everyone watching this video to stop engaging in bad faith arguments over bike lanes. We won't and don't need to convince everyone in the comments section. Our precious time and energy are far better spent on the bigger picture. Instead, we need to articulate a coherent, optimistic vision of a more livable future by sparking a value-based conversation about our social and societal aspirations, on which I'm convinced there's a great deal of consensus on safety, on health, on greenery, on equity, on sustainability, and on prosperity. Once we agree on the destination, we can have a more nuanced conversation about how to get there. We need to expand our movement to bring in those left behind by car dependence. There's a much bigger coalition waiting to be formed outside of the people already cycling, especially the young and elderly, the women, the people with disabilities or lower incomes. Many of them would hop on a bike in a heartbeat if we didn't require dodging through motor traffic from door to door. We must also rise above the culture war that separates us into tribes based on our mode of transportation, which only leads to inertia and inaction. There's a tremendous latent demand waiting to be mobilized and activated. Huge numbers that will support politicians willing to push against the status quo. Our mission is to ensure the silent majority is heard loud and clear. The last five images you've seen on the screen weren't created by artificial intelligence. They're recent photographs of cities where the Dutch Cycling Embassy has worked: Paris, Vienna, Miami, Austin, and Tirana. Pioneering cities that have recognized transformational change as possible, but only by reframing the conversation and asking, not what your city can do for cycling, but what cycling can do for your city.